Hi guys, I'll be trying to kill Lord of Cinder. Let me just go back to game. Alright, and we'll try Mercury and Dark damage. Probably will be too heavy, so we'll have to switch, I guess. Maybe we cast now. Let him come. Hit with both things. Okay, he got hit with the Mercury a bit. He's attacking me. No. Yes, I hit him. And got hit. Trading doesn't look too well. No. Black blow. Don't attack me. This might get him. It did. Awesome. More. He's probably using fire within, so he's gets more damage now. As much as I understand it. Maybe we should just roll away. Okay, this was weak. Alright. Roll away, we need now mana. And we're going to attack multiple times, maybe. I hate this stupid spear attack. Very spammy. Maybe we heal. Alright, attack again. He got hit, I guess. One more and we have him. But let's heal. Get mana and buff this stuff. Not maybe like this. Alright, can we attack now? Maybe we can. Well, that was really cool. It's really, really cool. No. No. Don't chase me like this. I hate you. Was I hit? Yes, I was hit. No, I don't want to trade. I want to heal. And maybe block. And no, I have to heal again. I'm probably dead now. This is going to kill me. No! One more, one more, please, one more. Okay, one more. No! No! Die! Please die! I don't want to die. You die now. You die. Okay. That's it for the Mr. Cinder. Whatever he is called. Can I get more? Maybe? Or not? Souls? Okay, levels. That's nice. Alright guys, so that's how we can do it. I think I got one hit with Mercury at the very beginning, but I guess it's not worth it because he is too fast. So I used part of the setup that I was showing in my first English video for the previous series when I was showcasing this drag spell from DLC. Just switch back to what I had. What's this? Yeah. So, for the damage, you need the marquee staff plus 10. You need 2 rings for magic damage because it's still a spell, it's a magic spell, so you need those 2 dragon rings. Then you need clutched ring for dark, not magic, because it's dark, and you need Lloyd's sword ring. Now it would be more damage if we had a dagger that improves magic damage. You can farm it from the candle people in great archives. But you have to drop it from them. I tried, but I didn't manage to do it yet. So I tried without it. It was enough. Also, in the second DLC, you can find a hat that gives you more damage from dark. It's similar to Crown of Dusk, but Crown of Dusk is only magical damage. So basically it's very messed up, because we have dark spells that benefit from various items. And I will just say it once again. So basically magic is mostly just magic spells, but also dark spells. Now, the Dragon Rings affect all magic spells. They don't affect miracles or pyromancies, but they affect all magic spells and dark spells. Clutched Ring affects either dark or magic, depending on the color, basically. Blue is magic and black is dark. Lloyd's Ring, which is supposed to only give bonus to physical, actually affects all magic, basically all damage that you are doing, is everything, even firebombs. So you have to basically use this setup: Lloyd's Ring, two rings for magical damage in general, and Clutched Ring for dark. But if you are using like a crystal spear spell, that you have to switch clutched dark to clutched magic, and then you can use Crown of Dusk. But if you want to use this Soul of Drag, you need a different item. It's like a sort of a mask on eyes, like the color is violet. I don't remember the name. It drops from an NPC in further part of second DLC. Basically, it's beyond first boss, so we can't have it yet. I mean, I'm going in sort of a sequence. Cinder is easier than bosses in second DLC. And Nameless King is more annoying than Cinder, so that's why Cinder was now, then will be probably Nameless King, because he has less HP. And then we can probably do either second DLC or first DLC. At this point doesn't really matter, but if I want to use Dark on the first DLC, I should have to go to second DLC first, get the full damage of the Drag spell, and then go back, do first DLC or finish the second DLC. Something like that. It's a little bit convoluted and messed up, but that's how I'm going in a sequence, boss after boss. So now we did Lord of Cinder, we could finish the game, but I will be now doing Nameless King, which will finish the main game, and then we'll be doing DLCs, probably maybe first boss in the second DLC, then maybe full first DLC, then the rest of second DLC, or something like this. We might switch it up. There is like six bosses in both DLC, if I remember correctly. So this will be another part of the same playlist, but this concludes the game, because Nameless King is optional. So at this point we could go to NG+. We kinda finished, but I'm also going to do Nameless King with Mage, probably as next video. I used what should I use? I used plus 9 Lotric, which is 65 stability. Of course should have better one, but I didn't push much into strength. What else? I had the great Moonlight Sword and Pyromancy Glove, which I didn't use. I also didn't use the sword. Yeah, that's it, I guess. And basically most damage, or full damage, almost full damage, aside from a little bit of Mercury, was everything done with Marquee stuff. So this spell from the beginning of second DLC can be actually used to kill Cinder. So if you have the DLC, you shouldn't go to Cinder first. You should first go to second DLC, grab the items, then level them up and kill Cinder with this. Or if you want, you can try Pyromancy, it also works. Or lightning, but actually you get best lightning spell from Cinder, so you'd have to use weaker lightning spells. Yeah, so that would be it, I guess. We defeated the boss, so I'm just going to make sure I don't go to second. Yes? No? Yes. What if I say no? Oh, it's the same. Okay, we don't have the second ending. I'm just going to switch it now. Take it away. Yeah, that's the ending. So, do you want to finish? No. Now we are going to spend our souls and then to Nameless King. Yeah, so that'll be it. I'm also going to show you my stats at the end of the game, sort of, because that is enough to kill Cinder. That would be a level 109. We have 27 vitality, or vigor it is, I guess. Attunement is 26, 10 into stamina, 8 into encumbrance. We don't need more. Can use the same armor all the time without putting any points here. 8 into strength, this is for the shield. 15 dexterity, this was probably for the claymore. No, it was claymore, bow, and something else, one more item. I was talking about in first episode. And then we just go intelligence, fate, intelligence, fate, intelligence, fate all the time until we go to at least 50, probably higher, because we want as much damage as possible. So that will conclude the build and pretty much the main game. And I'll see you guys in the optional fight with Nameless King very soon. See you around.